Guten Morgen, Eva.
Yeah, good morning.
Eva.
And welcome, everybody, and welcome, Tristan. And I'm glad you're here.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, the first time in Team Dach, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lots
Yeah.
of familiar faces.
Yeah.
And some not so familiar.
So I'll pass over the space holding to you. And if you
Okay.
accept, yeah.
Thank
And
you.
we see where we go today. Thank you.
Okay. Well, hello. I'm upside down on the other side of the world where it's winter and had the heater on all day. And I'm glad to connect with summer energy because I love the summer. So glad to connect with you. And I know some of you I haven't met really before, so I'll just say that I'm living in New Zealand and I live in the capital city in which is named Wellington, where I live here with my son in a little I found out a couple of weeks ago it's a wizard house here with my son, and it's been for this year a beautiful and challenging healing space, and it's slowly starting to shift into a more of a working space. And I really, so I've been holding space for the Possibilitator Training in New Zealand since the beginning of last year, so for more than a year now. And I really care about space holders, people finding the space they want to hold in their life and in Akiaki and in this village, these villages we are creating together, these radically responsible villages we are creating together. So I'm glad to connect with more, yeah, with you and with your possibilitator soul. So thank you for having me.
Yeah.
And I would like to know what I can do for you. And I would also like to know if you have maybe discoveries to share or celebrations to share, or if you're coming with some necessity or question into the space today. I think we have 1.5 hours. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes, I have a necessity today, which is, I think, very much connected to art, to women's culture, but I ask it anyway. I mostly live in the Harz Mountains, and there is a group, a Telegram group with about 450 people. And there's a woman space holding for it, and it started during the pandemic. And it's more like people who are alternative and want to be more conscious about thing being connected from that area, because this area is quite, you know, typical German little town area where like things like yoga or things like you know, conscious work is pretty new. So it's the possibility to connect people. But in this Telegram group, also people are mostly busy sharing either like frightening things, like wanting to make people aware about what's going on in the area. For example, posts about windcraft and what they do to the woods and stuff like that, or having like, I would say, gremlin conversations about, like, sometimes there's reactivity going on and then it's going down again. And the woman, I know her, she's a space holder. She's really keeping the context. She's really the guardian for the space. But I noticed that she kind of does it alone. Like she's not, like every time when I reach out to her and I also offered feedback and she was very thankful for that, but it's like I can't really reach out to her or like really connect to her. Like we are friends and we talk about the space, but she's not saying yes to having really a conversation in a physical space. That she's like, in my awareness, she's playing the lone wolf thing with that space and doesn't want really to, yeah, to open up so more people can contribute to what she actually creates there, because she's really, like I told her that once, like you're really the village weaver, like what you've done here is amazing because people can connect now, but what's next? Like now I feel like there's a next evolution of this space, but it's not, and I don't know how to bring that in either with my offers. And I offered once a rage club. And then she said, no, we don't do that here. Like she's, yeah. So I'm a bit stuck about that. And I ask for possibilities. What can I do about that? What can I do next? Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Christina, what is like, my question for you is, what is it that is so important for you? Like, this is something coming through you that seems like this would be important for you to change something or to bring something there that is missing. Would you say something about that?
What comes now is that I just feel sad. I don't want to force my offers there or want to change anything. It's just that I can't stay beside her. I just can't stay next to her.
You can't stay next to her because...
And I don't want to make a story that she doesn't want that. It's just the energy of our, like when we have a conversation, it's like, and I feel sad about that. And when I have a question.
Yeah, well that kind of answers the question. Well, it gives some answer. When I hear you express your sadness, that would bring me a lot in connection with you if I would be her. Like I can feel the connection force coming through you about that.
Yeah, I guess where I'm stuck is that I have the story in my head because I want to share that with her the whole time. And I have the story in my head. I cannot tell her because there's not, but maybe I just share it on Telegram. In a chat.
I think I missed a part of the sentence. Like you cannot, like did you say it's not possible to meet like physically?
I offered several times to meet and either she's busy or she doesn't answer.
Okay.
So I have the story, I can only share my sadness in the physical space because then it makes more sense, but then I just text her that. So it's actually very simple.
Well, I met a guy this week, and he really cared about the culture in his business that he was part of, and I asked him like deeper about what is so important for him, and this big anger came in his system about the, like, the culture that he wants to be in his business. And I never really saw that about how someone could care so much, like as a kind of a conventional modern culture business, about the connection between the people and the community that was there. And so it's, I think if you really care about it, then it's why not go and express all this, everything that you feel about that, to the person, no, to this woman.
Mm-hmm.
Like, really make the space for that, that you say, okay, I went there and made this 100%. I expressed my whole sadness. I told her how important this is to me, and she can take it or leave it. But it's a gold that you have for her. It's a big gift.
For me, it's important to distinguish. I sense two things in there. Like, one is your wish to connect with this woman, like maybe more on a friendship level, and the other one is your care for this group and kind of what you sense what's next for this group, how this could evolve into more responsible space. And I think it's important to be clear, like distinguish the two things, so that it also becomes clearer for her.
Thank you.
And Christina, I have the question. So my impression is something is keeping you from just, you know, giving distinctions into the group, bringing your context into the group chat, or just being there and maybe posting websites about Gremlin or whatever. And and is what is holding you back from just deciding that you're also a space holder for this group?
One thing is because technically I'm not, like, technically in the Telegram thing, and the biggest part is that I feel fear of her not agreeing with it. And because it happened before, and then I got a big message from her that that's not the context of the group, and then I actually let myself be silenced by her, because I don't want to go in concurrence. I don't want to fight. And
yeah. So I sense also this, and I heard you speak about culture to culture conversation the last weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Like over and over again, it seems to me like something that you're practicing, and also that you seem to meet here again, this culture to culture conversation possibility. And I'd almost propose you also to write down, to sit for you and write down and have this, make these distinctions or the scanning just for yourself before you a meeting or a connection with her, about what is it that is missing to bridge over? Like, what is it missing that maybe your love, your care for this space that is so natural for you, that is just, and maybe also so clear, like just clear. How could it be that it's not, like, someone else is not able to take it as the love, but as a threat? And to find out where you, how you could say it differently, how do you build the bridge into this other culture personality, so that your love gets really across it? And maybe that's the expression of the sadness, but also maybe the context, just the context of, hey, there's different cultures. I'm bringing something new. And
I'm writing the things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have, I mean, I'm curious to maybe hear other people's voices on this too, but I found part of being a possibilitator is to like step into getting like getting whacked, you know, from all different directions. So when you go into something that you care about, the beeps can really hurt. You know, it's like you try something, so it might be really tempting to go back out of the forest and avoid the whole pain of it, and to stay, like to go and take the hits and be hurt and let the hurt like transform you and change you is powerful, I would say.
Yeah, I got feedback from Anna about not letting feedback in yet, like that there's a child, that there's still a contamination with child. And
yeah,
also saw that in the reconstruction process on I think it was Tuesday, and I can see the connection of I feel really a lot of fear standing in this group, and then just posting something, and it's not so much the beeps, it's more my own thing of going back and forth and having go back and forth and not going completely like this again. And I will do it anyway. So.
Go.
Oh, yeah.
Go.
Please write us in the group.
Yeah.
Your successes and your insuccesses.
Yeah, and I also noticed while listening to you that how much I'm still questioning my own context. Like, or do it really quickly, that I question my own context or not really standing in it. Okay, this is what I do as soon as I get a beep, and that's maybe not helpful. And that.
Yeah. It helps to really take the time to let the beep land accurately. So, because you can take a beep and let it hit your whole body and say, everything is bad. Everything's not working, or I have to throw the whole context away and start again. Or you can let the beep.
So far.
So let the beep find like the acupuncture point in you. Like, what is it really? Where does it really need to land? What assumption is it telling me about? Or yeah, so acupuncture beeps, and it's your job. To make, you know, some people are really good at giving beeps. They say, it's this and this and this. And you say, oh, I can't do it again. You say, shut up. No, I'm not saying you can't do it. It's about this. Right? So this is like if someone was giving you the acupuncture feedback. But you can also do the same thing on the other side to take care about that you receive the acupuncture feedback. For me, it helps to give it a lot of time and like not to shy away from it and to talk to people about it. I'd really love to hear from a few other people, any discoveries or celebrations or necessities.
I want to celebrate that last weekend we had the first ETB here in fun stuff. Yay! And it works.
What happened?
Please?
What happened?
It was a grandiose, fabulous ETB it was more an ET blep than in ETB. And we had a lot of really a lot of high-level fun. Sabine has been there too. And so we had, I think it was a good ride on the magic cloud. So for me, it works. Sabine, you can tell something more. How it was? Was it on the other side?
On the other side, I was in the middle of.
Yes. We all.
Yes. So it was a mix. So the half of the people, for them was the first time, and the other half, it was the second or whatever. And then we built a team from the first day on. And we had a lot of deep conversations and also spaces and processes between the sessions. And it was touching, and there was a lot of deep transformation for all of us. It's hard to bring it on the point or to say something specific. Yeah.
I have a coaching for you, Sabina, which is to take like one thing for you that touched you or you got in a way, and like package it for us as though in a way where we can experience that, like where we can learn from something that you discovered.
Yeah, thank you. So my discovery was that when I'm in the training or in the session and we do this experiment, then I'm all in, and then I'm allowed to be there with my energy and to give through what comes in and so on. And I'm in all my bodies, I'm as tall as I am. And if I go into the pause or out of the session, then it's an automatic move to shrink myself. And we also had a very precious space after the ETB because there were four people left. And then we had the ongoing session because that was the opportunity to share every move inside and to really get precious feedback in the moment or at the moment or direct, I don't know. So I learned a lot in this space after the ETB, and I learned that I have, so my story, I'm not dangerous, and the story doesn't works anymore. So I have to be aware of my energy, and I have to be, I have to take the responsibility for what I bring into the space, kind of this.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sabina. I'm glad you're not dangerous anymore.
Me too.
I feel joy about this report because we've all been in that house, in that building, in that room where the ETB took place. We had our meeting from our group here. So it feels kind of familiar, and I can somehow imagine what's been going on there.
I am practicing saying things that don't work. So I want to share something that where I'm feeling a bit, I'm feeling sad and angry. We had from our local possibility team yesterday, we had a meeting and the plan was to finally write our codex. We've been trying to do that since a few months. And when we started, a woman was emotional about the last meeting and was a lot in child emotions and said she couldn't really write the codex with us if she couldn't have space for that. And in the end, we didn't write a single sentence. And I'm angry because I gave on Tuesday after the reconstruction, I gave my gremlin the job to scan what other gremlins are up to. And I was only seeing gremlins everywhere, including my own. And even though I was aware of gremlin energy in the space or not clearly expressed gremlin purpose that was being played out unconsciously in the space, even though I was aware of that, I was standing at this edge and was like, I don't know how to shift the space into something that is working. I'm also angry because I've been sitting in groups so much where it's just people are just, we're just talking. Many people are making proposals. None is really, you know, brought through to the end so that we know what we are doing together now as a next step. And even that, I can see it. I was sitting in there and I didn't know how to shift it. And I also feel fear about that because I want to build next steps here. We're navigating towards building a bridge house, and I feel really afraid that these dynamics will crush us. And yeah.
I would also like to say something, like Eva, Marcus and I were in the same team and I was holding space for that team. And I've also been reflecting on it. And somehow just during the day yesterday, it dawned on me that I've been completely hooked by this emotion and that, I don't know, my good boy box or my own fear, emotional fear, kind of, I don't know. And also like a conditioning, like, okay, there is this big emotion and I have to kind of deal with it. I have to give it space. It's like, and just like a few hours later, and also Eva's feedback, and it was like, I got completely hooked, and also I was in it and I wasn't able to shift the space at all. It's just like blank.
What you have been frightened of to say stop or no to the conversation that happens.
It's like a whole complex, like.
I ask about your fear.
Yeah. Oh. Well, yeah, my fear was that actually she would run out crying and totally
go.
yeah, kind of lose it and hate us and leave. And maybe even be like pretty destabilized and having nobody to take care of her.
Well, I have a proposal right now, which would be to practice now with the acupuncture, letting it deeper. And it means, I've never done this before, right? So we can experiment, but the possibility that came to me is to like take this, what is there, this what happened, and like to let this come, like bring this into your body, yeah, and to say, oh, ah, and let like the sound be there, and like so to go like right into it here with us, and we, and that we could hold space for you just to let this get deeper, and we can see what happens with that. So do you, Ava and Oliver, want to do that, if we would hold space for you for that, and maybe Marcus too?
Yes.
Yeah,
like you mean us going at the same time?
Yeah, just yeah. Go at the same time. So you take just like how I described it, and the rest of us, we're just going to hold space, and you let this hit the point. Let this hit the point in you. Marcus, are you also, are you holding space, or are you doing it?
I'm having, like, I have a different story than the two of them for this, happened yesterday. So I still have beeps and pain.
Yeah.
So I practice letting in what was my, yeah, what I received.
Great. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So
yeah.
Go ahead. We are with you.
Go on.
Go, Ava, go, Oliver, go, Marcus. Yeah, let it go right sharp.
Yeah.
Right deep. Go.
Yes, Ava, go.
And go deep.
Yeah, right in there. Let this be so thorough as you can. Yeah. Like, right to the deep sound. Yeah, go all the way through. Yeah, go, Marcus.
Yeah, this is ein Eva, sei damit.
Yes. Go, Ava, all the way through. Okay. Yes, it's doing great, Oliver.
Lass die Worte kommen.
Yes.
I don't want emotions to allow the space to be destroyed. I'm not in that game.
Yeah, and try not to fight it, Ava. Like, let it just sink deeper in you, like without fighting against it or pushing against it, or trying to never let it happen again. Like, instead of going against, let it deeper.
I feel fear that we just
great.
Fall apart.
Great.
Yes. Yeah, bleib da, Oliver. Bleib da, genau.
Yeah, great, Oliver. Yeah.
And that she will talk bad about possibility management and how rigid it is and how control freaks we are and only wanting to control the time all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm afraid to be seen as this bad guy and this rigid
and feel this fear.
Person.
Go through this fear, Eva.
Oliver, go.
Yeah.
Go, Oliver.
Oh, and I'm sad and angry to not be seen.
Yeah,
like,
go.
What's really important for me? Oh.
Yeah, bleib da, Markus. Yeah, da.
Eva, there's a layer that you're at now, and I think it is about letting it crumble. Like what you said, I'm scared of letting it all fall apart. I'll let that layer just all fall apart. Like Isabel said as well. The fear be there.
Yes.
Yeah.
Genau, so Oliver, lass mit ins Becken.
Through the next layer, yeah.
Oh, Becken mitnehmen. Oh.
Nein.
Oh. Yes.
Go.
Don't go there, Eva.
Yeah. Marcus, say what that layer is.
I don't want you to
erase. Go there, Eva. Go.
Something you don't understand.
Let it flow through you.
Oh.
Yeah.
I am afraid of this meme.
Oh.
Yeah, yes. Go, Marcus. Go. Go all the way through. Yeah, right.
I allow the meme to be in the spaces.
No.
I have no control. We're just going to slop into all emotions at the same time. It's just going to be a huge mess with no purpose.
Yeah, and feel this fear, Eva. Go there. It's fear. Go there. A big fear, huge fear, all falling apart.
No, I'm not going to scream because of my neighbor. I'm not in the space for emotion. Huge discharge.
It's not about scream. It's letting your body feel it. Go in the shaking of the fear in your system. Let it sink until your uterus falls down in you.
Yes. Yes, this.
I'm sad because
I don't want that. It's not
go,
my
Eva.
Purpose.
Go, Oliver.
Yes, Oliver.
I'm sad because I'm completely giving away my center and I'm kind of making these compromises and believing that I'm a good person and I'm kind of hating it inside. It feels like betraying myself for the sake of
something. Go.
It fucking makes me sick.
Go.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, great.
Yeah, I'm most angry that I'm kind of betraying myself and not taking myself seriously.
Yes, Marcus,
pleasing
go there.
Other people. Fuck.
Yes.
Hey.
And I'm also sad and afraid because I don't know how to kind of take care of other people and hold my clarity.
Hey, thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Just let any echoes be there. Thank you. Yeah. We're just at the sense about to hear from to just hear from the team. So us who were holding space, what did you notice about how Eva, Oliver, or Marcus were blocking it to go all the way deep? They're blocking the feedback to go all the way deep, or the pain to go all the way deep. So for example, I noticed Eva, this thing you said, I don't want that. I don't want that. And it felt like this is one way, like a way you use boundaries to block yourself from feeling pain. And so from like letting this deeper land deep, more deeply in you, in a way where you would have to change, or you would transform by yourself without to block it, is something I noticed. Would you share what you're feeling, Eva?
I'm so afraid to be washed away by this meme and not being able to hold a context that I want to participate in. It's like black and white. It's that meme or this meme. And
which meme?
My meme is, I want her to be responsible with her emotions, and it's okay to go 20 minutes into that, and then it's okay to say our purpose of this meeting was to write the codex. It's totally okay to say, and now you can take that into a process. And her meme is, I want to go with whatever arises. I don't want to be rigid to hold on to an old plan, but I want to let everything that is alive in the space be visible and have space. And I can't, I'm so, that's so,
yeah.
That's so meaningless for me. And I've been in so many meetings and wasted so much time with people being in irresponsible reactivity to each other. I'm not going to, I'm going to leave that space. I also said, if we're going to continue, I will leave. I'm not prepared to do that. That is a boundary. It's my life energy. It's my time. It's just such a no.
You can't be in connection with a gremlin, Eva.
What is the feedback? Like,
yeah. Well, you're feeling the pain right now. You're feeling it now. But the thing is, stop. Like, the coaching I want to give you is to stop trying to make the boundary about it. Like, what if you would just feel the pain about that this gremlin took over the space and you lost so much, you know, space. Yeah, exactly.
I'm afraid that I will never reach through to her. I will just not make it through her child and through her gremlin defenses. I will just not make it.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, and Eva, also then let the pain also inform you, like, what is important for you. So is something coming through you that is important for you? What is that?
To make the boundary for her gremlin without cutting off the connection to her heart.
Not about the boundary, about the space.
Yeah.
About spaces.
And let yourself feel it, Eva. Now your attention is
go,
still on
go.
Her. It's still on her. What is it that you want?
I want clarity in the space. I want responsibility in the space. I want to create. I want to move forward.
For what? Clarity for what? Like, forward for what? Responsibility for what? What is coming through you?
For being able to heal instead of being in reactivity. I want to go into the process of chewing on the codex so that we can hear from each other, so that we can do this fine adjustment of, okay, what is coming through you, what is coming through me, and and get real about it. And being precise and
yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
The when it came through you about what you want was a lot more powerful than the boundary, the fighting against.
Mm.
And when you create what you want, the boundary kind of happens by itself.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to put energy against someone else.
And exactly, my sense is there's also a layer deeper what you want about connection, because you said don't want the connection with gremlin. So maybe you go there too. Like you said what you want about the codex, you say what you want about the space, and what is it about?
Well, yeah, I just want to be able to be connected to her and somehow swim through these child layers and her defenses. I just want to be connected to her.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe your own defense and your own not showing your hurt that is hurting you not opens the door to her to go another way. So So go there where you were right now. And then maybe she doesn't have to do what she does, because you make you are seen in your, was heißt Schmerz? Not hurting.
Pain.
In your pain. You are seen in your pain and you are feeling there and you're going emotional or whatever, but you show you.
But I'm afraid to do that, because then I have the impression I'm not walking my own talk.
Maybe she only feels your sword and it is so sharp. And I am connected with you in your pain right now. I can see you right now. I can feel you. This is what is needed in this space. It's not only clarity about writing something written. It's more. Go there.
What would you share what you're feeling right now, Isabel?
What?
Would you share what you're feeling right now?
What my feeling is right now?
Yeah.
I'm sad about I'm sad about this. It's like I can sense the sword in front of Eva, and it's we made exercises with sword, and it's like I want something from you, and it's going with the sword first, and it's hurting, it's like I'm hiding behind the sword, and it's about letting the sword going down, feel and go not going in front, better going at the side, and talking about what do I want to go, and what's the same, where are you looking for? I want to go in the same direction, and not I want something from you and I'm staying and standing in front of you. It's something energetic about this, and I can sense this, and it's I have this sadness about not being in connection. Yes.
Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm.
would love to also hear from Oliver, or you, Marcus, where you are at, or what landed in you.
Right now, I'm very glad about your process, Eva. Getting that clarity about, like, really being vulnerable. And yeah, that's it for me right now. I don't have any clarity on, like, how I can keep my clarity and be in connection.
I would propose maybe someone has something for Oliver, one of the space holders, about how Oliver is blocking or taking feedback in another direction, or something that you would not, that it would not transform you. It would not let you go totally liquid and become someone else.
It felt like you went to an old story. I did it wrong. It was a kind of self. You made yourself small, and there was no space for other possibilities, for what can I do to say what I'm take a stand for, or for how can I be in contact? How can I bring my gifts into the space to nourish the space?
You pulled yourself back physically in the situation. You make yourself small, and you seems to be in a mixture about sadness and fear I didn't really got it if it's about the reaction of the other person, or is it about your own shadows?
Could you say more about the shadow?
I only get it because I couldn't hear it. I only get it energetically. And what I get was something like, if I would act as if I would like to act, I would be a bad person. I would be, and I don't want to do it. And in no case, I don't want to be that kind of person, which another person which say, oh, I'm so hurt, to hit the person and say, no, that doesn't work for me. I want something different. That they don't offer your heart to the other person the whole time, as you put it on a tablet, to say, oh, eat my heart, please. And if you don't do it, it's not enough. And it was only an energetically imprint.
Thank you.
And would you come nearer right now? Because it happens right now for me. You are too. You are from the monitor. Come nearer. I want to see you.
I want to feel your presence.
Yes.
Go, Isabel.
Go. It's very different.
For me, there's a huge space between the victim story and the persecutor story. And it's like you are on this side or you are on this side, but you are seldom and very so in the space between. And this is the space where you are the creator and the where you fall in with your heart and with your love and with all your gifts. And this is, it's like, I cannot be there. It's not allowed to be there. It seems you have a story in your about this. It's not allowed for you to going in this space between.
Yeah.
And my feedback is if you find the savior in you in that story of being between victim and persecutor, like if you find in yourself what is it that pulls you out of this situation or pulls you out, or what is the completion of this drama, like how do you do that when you are in that, and find what is the emotional fear about it, then you can also switch out of the drama and into using your fear for not falling into that drama.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Oliver.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Oliver.
I really resonate. It makes such a big difference when you are forward. Can really feel it. Yeah. Thank you.
It's the whole travel for me to be here right now with you, because as I said, I think I had such a bit different story from about the space from yesterday, and I had the experience of I stood in for something different than Eva and Oliver, and right now I'm sad and glad to be here with you as a team, and there's these sentences coming in of kind of like I'm held, or universe or Gaia is carrying us, because I experienced myself as being part of something yesterday which was bigger than me and our group, and I'm thankful that in this group right now the process continues, like the process of both of heart and clarity, and some of like the things you said I wasn't able to say yesterday, and yeah, I'm somehow the experiences, I'm glad that it is also been taken care of here. Yeah. And also I feel that I'm somehow something protecting in me. Like I'm feeling fear in which I feel rather numb, and sadness. Yeah. And
what is the fear about, Marcus? Yeah.
I have fear to not be understood, and
go
to be dismissed because I might say something that is out of range of acceptance for other people, out of range of yeah, something like this. And I'm also feeling the sadness and going back to the fear, I feel fear to start to speak for a principle that wants to come through me.
In which body they come through you?
Both my emotional and my archetypal body.
What does it want to say to us? If you would let it speak right now.
That I held space yesterday for a principle of the principle of connection, and I was there to not let it be crushed in the idea or in the experience of that there is a child ego state trying to transport this principle of connection and not being accepted because it's a child ego state. And I
go, Marcus. Try to stay in contact with us. Yeah. There's another layer. It's a deeper layer also. Maybe it has a sound. Thorough. Go.
You mean a different feeling or
No, the yeah. Go. Just let the whole energy come through. You're holding it a little bit back. Yeah. Let it come right into the space.
Yeah.
All the way to us.
Then I'm landing in a mixed emotion space of fear, anger, and sadness.
Yeah, don't analyze it. Just let it come like, right all the way to us. All the way. Like forward. Forward to us. It's not just for your bubble, it's for us. Let it come all the way. Yeah, all the way into the screen. To these beings. Go.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, go.
Yeah, it's like let it come into the ground, into the world. Yeah. The whole sound, the whole force.
Something is blocking. It's like this round thing here. I feel fear being shot at or something.
Because you feel fear of being shot at because
I'm saying something that addresses everybody. And and there's a structure in people that is not prepared for this. That is not okay with this.
Yes.
And I'm speaking to this collective structure and
So you wanna adapt yourself to what is okay and what is not okay for us.
Is this a provocation or a quest? Like what?
It's a question. That's what you're saying. Let me try a different way. What if you would not adapt yourself to what is okay and what is not okay for us? Do you want to try that?
Yeah. And I even made the distinction. It's not you. And when you say us, it's not us. I don't see you as this. What is defending is this. It is a structure. It's the fabric of something in you or something in people. And it's so powerful. Yeah. It's so powerful to dismiss whatever threatens it.
Yes.
And I'm so sad because
go.
It kills connection in any way.
Yes.
And all these proofs that this way of connection is not okay. This is not how we do it, how we connect. It's all that, there's so many. The structure is so powerful because it sees so many proofs of what is incorrect. It says you gotta do it this way, otherwise we're not okay with you or something. And beyond there, like there's something which is, I call it like the principle way, and it's not it's not always accurate or shape nice or logic or
yes,
it's a principle.
So you have this principle coming through you, Marcus, and it's meeting this place, this fabric, and the that you're feeling where things are okay or not okay, and it's so powerful, and there's like this meeting point.
Yeah. And I
and you're stuck.
Holy
there.
Shit. Oh.
Mm-hmm.
I have the experience of it taking so much matrix to hold this principle up and do not fall into any other ego states or something because of this structure, because of the because the power, the structure is so powerful in deconstructing.
And what?
Because the structure is so powerful in deconstructing the being that tries to transport this principle. And yesterday in this space I could kind of connect to Gandhi's lineage with it. In school, I've seen this film where he's standing, like he and his guy, his people, they're coming to this, I don't know what it is again, but they're coming to this group of people again and again, and
all these yeah. other people to be, they slap them with their sting. And Gandhi and other people, they're coming again and again. And they're not fighting back because they're not who they are.
Yeah.
And it takes almost like Gandhi like Matrix to come yeah. over next weekend towards this. It's almost like a tank or something. Stand there and be like, yes.
Yeah.
I take your hits because I'm showing you I am something else. And
yeah. I have a possibility for you, Marcus. And this is, you said this is like the circle is like in front of you there, right? This.
Not anymore. I spoke a lot. Now it's.
Is it there? Yeah. It's in front of you. Yeah.
More it's not. No, it's more like a net or something in front of me.
Yes.
With these little needles.
Yes. Okay. Okay. I have possibility just to take this and just energetically take this behind you. Like to take this, to bring this behind you right now. And yeah, and then keep letting the energy flow. Just keep letting the energy flow.
Oh.
Yeah, and connect with us.
Oh. Oh.
Welcome, Marcus. Welcome the force coming through you. Welcome the force of connection coming through you. I welcome that. Thank you. Thank you for being connection. I want to open the space. Does anyone have anything for Marcus right now? Mostly appreciation would be my sense.
When you said that this principle of connection is coming through you, something shifted inside of me and I could see more of you. I'm grateful for that.
I feel the principle coming through you, and I will invite you to lean on inside your heart on the back. Then it really could work, and you don't try to hold it. Yes. Thank you.
Marcus, I appreciate you for your courage to stand in your truth, no matter which forces oppose it.
I had the whole time the question, what is the force? What is the purpose? They pushed you, and now it's not longer hidden. I can see it and I can feel it. And now I can see you. I can feel you. Thank you for open this up and show this.
I had this inner picture of standing you as the wizard alone on the mountain in the wind, and right now you came up from the mountain in the circle of people with us. Mm-hmm. and it came from the earth through all your body, like something like this, and you are in between us in the circle of people and not alone on the mountain. This is the wizard with us. Thank you for this. And go.
I feel more fear now being in a space with you, like, but in this way of kind of a safety or holding space in another way. And I also, it's like I can almost feel how your shoulder feels on my shoulder right now, even though I only see you on the screen. It's like I can really feel me standing next to you. And I also feel joy about what you shared.
And you are a bit taller. What? Say it again.
And you are a bit taller to me.
Yeah. Thank you, Marcus.
Yeah, thank you all.
Oh, thank you for the experiment. Almost like three healing processes.
I think
life can be like a long, slow healing process where we don't have to wait for space holders. Yeah. One thing that really landed in me with being with you in this space is like the power of being a yes to what is coming through you and what is coming through the other people, and to like let the yes burn.
Yeah.
Like you chose every space you chose to be in, you chose for yourself or something. So it's like to be a yes for that.
Tristan, I thank you for the distinction that if somebody speaks, you told to Marcus, don't go forward, speak to us. It's not for your bubble, and really to speak out of the bubble. It was for me. It was that what I was missing, and I didn't know how to say it. What I thought about, and I think that was so great for me. Thank you. For the distinction.
Thank you. Yeah.
And I love the, it didn't work with you in I think we met perhaps, but what do you say about acupuncture to speak like that? And this was that what was what I am feeling about mimetic constructs and how to work with people energetically. It's really like, I see the puncture and I want to hit it. Yes.
Yeah.
I feel home with that.
Yeah.
And don't let people think it's you're hitting them with a whole car. And you're crashing them completely or something. But really, make sure your puncture lands.
Yeah. We can make it like that.
Yeah.
Like kinesiology, perhaps. So, like.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yesterday, I think a new becoming friend. It was a man. I met him and we had the type of connection where I started with, I sense that there's this shadow principle of arrogance in between of us. We both bring it. And so we talked about that and it could move a bit to the side. And then we talked about the next thing. So basically we got to know each other by bringing up the shadow world and taking it out. Like, that was the strategy we found so that we could actually connect. And eventually, because there was a lot of precision in it, he said about it, I think one of his masters or something, that the guy said, precision is love.
Then you have no hidden subjects, which if you are precise, you could not hide something, shadow principles behind. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. I want to share a story because last week I held space for a possibility team and it's been just like you guys. And it's been a long time since I held space for a possibility team and I was really, really scared And I spent hours preparing myself, like walking around in circles, practicing the context I wanted to land. And by the time I got there, I was so worked up and like I was just frozen. And the whole thing was terrible. It was the torturous 2 hours. And I, at some point, I said, okay, stop. I need possibilities now. Please give me possibilities how I can relax and hold space for this team without just like I'm so tense. It's falling to pieces. And there was a big expectation that I had on myself, and I could go liquid about that. And we kept going. And then afterwards, I was still, you know, I really wanted to beat myself up about it and go in a big swamp about it. And for probably about 3 days, this was like lingering on the edge. And I made the similar practice, like the same practice that we've done today of just, okay, letting it stay there, letting it work on me. And one man who was in the team with me, he called me up and he wanted to give me some feedback. And he found it terrible, the team. He told me, he said, this was so bad. I really wanted to find my way into possibility management. And this just made me bounce off again. And I really, really appreciated it that I said, yeah, same for me. It was so bad for me too. And he was like, what, really? Yeah. And this, the collaboration of this guy just talking to me about it was so, and it, you know, so beautiful. And we talked again about it in a couple of days, and he wanted to come to the next one to see, you know, what would shift. And so the next one was yesterday, and it was way better. Far more fun. And the whole thing that I got from the liquid state was, I don't actually have to try anything to be a space holder. It's like, I love holding space naturally. So, like, I love it. When I talk to people on the phone, sometimes it turns into a possibility team, mini possibility team together, just without that I have to try anything. And this could, like, blossom just by staying with the pain of how terrible this team was. And all week I've been able to just relax, and my practice has been like to be natural.
Yeah.
And it's, you know, still a bit bumpy, and I still have these thoughts like, oh, this, you know, not fast enough, and this was not elegant enough, and oh shit, now they're doing a healing process and the Dach Possibilitator team, that's not supposed to happen. all this stuff, and fuck it.
Yeah.
Yes, please do.
So it helps to, when you have a shit, you know, when you hold space for something and it turns to shit, it helps to call each other up and talk about how shit it was and keep going.
Yeah.
Thank you, Tristan.
Stay forward.
You're welcome.
Yeah,
thank you. Welcome, team.
Thank you, team.
Thank you, Tristan. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Yeah.
Thank you, well. Too.
I'm very glad.
Great to connect with you. Yeah.
Up to New Zealand. I didn't know that I have this long arms.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good day.
Yes.
See you next time.
Bye. See you.
Bye.
See you.
Bye.